Malo le soifo mawa male langi mama, malo mo e lau maria ahu eiki moelere ai kai ngā honokotoa. Joining us via Zoom is the Honourable Minister of Social Development. We have Honourable Carmel Sepuloni. Malo e lau maria, Carmel.
Malo le lai, John.
Thank you so much for fitting us in. Firstly, Minister, how are you and your family doing? You know, we're now at the fourth time we've done a lockdown here in Aotearoa. How are things at home?
Oh, they're good. I think we're all kind of used to this now. We don't want to have to get used to this, but, you know, we are. And everyone's just doing their thing. So looking forward to when we're out of alert level three. But for now, just following the rules.
Fantastic. Now, Minister, we're now in a week-long level three lockdown in Auckland with the rest of the country at alert level two. What support is there for our workers and our businesses?
Yeah, so we've got today, we will be opening up the wage subsidy again for employers to be able to support and pay their employees because they may not have been able to work. There's also the short-term absence payment for those that maybe needed to get tested and then can't go to work. So employers can access that, as well as the leave scheme, which is will cover people up to 2 weeks if they have to take leave for longer because of COVID. All of those things are in place. Employers can proactively access those, but it's important that workers know as well so that they can have a conversation with their employer if they're in the situation where their employer is not so proactive or not in the know about what supports are available.
So the businesses can apply from today, and also the money will get paid out coming on the next coming Monday, so next Monday.
Starting payouts on Monday next week. So it's been a very quick turnaround with the wage subsidy with every iteration that we've had, and we want to continue that.
Talk to me about contractors. Is there any help for them?
Oh, look, you know, with regards to those that might be in casual work, they can still access some of these supports as well. People that are self-employed contractors, they can also access some of the support. So, you know, check out the Ministry for Social Development website to check the criteria to see that you're eligible and make sure that you are accessing whatever support that you're entitled to during this time.
Now, the lack of money coming in will impact families. What support have you given to community agencies to help them out?
So last year, we obviously had to turn some funding around really quickly with the immediate response that was needed on the ground to families who may have been struggling. But we also knew that the next 2 years were going to be particularly difficult. So what we did at that point was we actually injected about $250 million of funding, which was COVID recovery funding for social services. And that went to whānau order agencies and a range of other organisations, knowing that it wasn't just last year that we were going to perhaps have to change alert levels and families were perhaps going to be struggling. So what we're hearing so far is that many of our organisations, our social services, are well placed given the funding that they got last year. A few have required a little bit of extra funding, but mostly people will be what the agencies or the social services have said they have the resource they need. They are seeing a demand, but they are able to meet that demand.
So with the demand, are we talking about food banks and the like?
Yeah, so that's certainly been a big part of it. Obviously, if people lose jobs or have reduced hours and they're already on low incomes, then they do struggle financially. And so food is one of the main things that people are reaching out for. I am hearing from social services that this time around, there's also heightened stress and anxiety for young people. So I really want to remind our young people that, you know, Youth Line is available to them. Also, we've got Bubblegum in South Auckland who are doing outbound calling to young people to check in, to see if they're okay, to see if they need anything. So we have a range of social services that are working. I really want to commend the work of our frontline workers for the way in which they are responding.
Yeah, that's fantastic to hear some of our local community groups lending a helping hand as well. Now, a lot of families, Minister, have been struggling for some time. How else can you help them or your ministry can help them during this time? Are there some emergency food grants via the work and income?
So we still have, of course, our general line, which is 0800 559 009. That's the Ministry for Social Development's general line. And we have put in place a dedicated 0800 number for the Papatoetoe community as well, those that are connected in some way to Papatoetoe High School. And that number continues. I won't announce it on here, John, because it is a dedicated line for them given their circumstances, but they've all been given that number, and we have received a number of calls over the last week from those families seeking different types of assistance.
Yeah, that was the other thing I wanted to touch on, was the helpline. I know that you have help specifically for the community in Papatoetoe with this growing cluster in Auckland as well. Is there anything else you can add to that?
Just acknowledging some of our Pacific providers that are doing work at this time. So South Seas, Ōtara Health, Vakatautua and the Whanau are four of our key Pacific organisations that are working to support our communities and reminding people that actually Vakatautua does have an 0800 line as well, which is 0800 652 535. And they are available to provide support in, I think, Cook Islands language, Tongan, Samoan, and then maybe one other language, but those are the three that I know that they can provide support in.
That's very good to hear. Speaking of getting the message out, are you satisfied with the government's messaging? I know that that was some of the issues this week that was raised about some community groups in South Auckland were still congregating for a lotu or church service. What's your point of view on that?
Well, MPP, or Ministry of Pacific Peoples, has been working furiously with the Ministry of Health to get the key messages out across the course of this week and also previously when we've been through restrictions in nine different Pacific languages. So they have been doing that work around key messaging. Also, a reminder, if you ring the 0800 559 009 MSD number and you need support in another language, you can say that and they can get that for people as well. There is a lot of work going on to get the key messages out in Pacific languages. I think if people have examples of where they feel that that hasn't been strong enough, they really should feed that through so that we can get quite specific on where perhaps there wasn't a message that was put around in enough Pacific languages. Some of our MPs, I think Jenny Salesa is one of them, post everything in every different language that comes through. And so we are trying to get the messages out there so that our people have access to the information when English isn't their first language.
Do you have a message for some of our Pasifika people that are kind of still ignoring the rules and, there are still talks of some church groups are still going ahead, some kava groups, what would you like to say to them?
Look, firstly, I'd like to say that the vast majority of our Pacific people are following the rules, and I want to commend our Pacific community for being part of the team of 5 million and doing the right thing. So let's start there. I think every ethnic group, every different ethnic community will have a few people who are not following the rules. I would like to say, firstly, it's about personal accountability. We have a responsibility to each other to keep our communities safe. And as Pacific people, we abide by that collective obligation and sense of responsibility. And so I would hope that anyone who's not following the rules would change their behaviour quickly, because that is not sitting well, it doesn't sit well with who we are as Pacific people. And then secondly, I think we've got to hold each other to account too. So if we see family members or friends who are breaking the rules, then we need to confront them in a respectful way, but we do need to, about the importance of sticking to the guidelines with regards to this particular alert level.
Minister. Now, before this week-long lockdown in Auckland, you did announce some support for people needing to take time off work to get tested and await their results at home. Is that still in place?
That is still in place, I think. Yesterday, the last numbers I got, I think around 600 people already this week had applied for it. I will say, John, sometimes it does require the worker to bring it up with the employer. That's not ideal. But, I do encourage our people to also, our working Pacific people, to also find out what's available and to find a way to have that conversation if your employer is not forthcoming with that information because they don't know or they're not proactive.
Right. And finally, Minister, what's your advice for our people who are feeling anxious about the current situation at this time? There's been some wonderful developments with the rollout of the vaccine here in Aotearoa. What would you like to say to our community?
I'd like to say, John, that we will get through this. We've got through it before, and we will get through it again. There are supports in place, and you know, I would encourage people not to be marred to access any support that they need to help themselves and their family. Also, just a reminder for anyone that does lose their job, we've put a whole lot of investment into MSD to support people to get into employment as well, and to try and speed up that process so that they can move from one job to the other if they are in that position. So we will get through this and access the support that's there and support each other.
Aupito, popo, aupito. Honourable Minister Carmel Sepuloni, whakwhitaite e le lava, mālo aupito for making time for Tagata Pasifika.
Mālo aupito, John.